स्टार्ट।
हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग. दिस इज सूर्या अग्रवाल हियर, जूनियर रेसिडेंट फ्रॉम वडोदरा एसबीकेएस मेडिकल इंस्टीट्यूट. टुडे माय टॉपिक इज एमआरआई इवैल्यूएशन ऑफ एपिलेप्सी विद क्लिनिकल कोरिलेशन. एपिलेप्सी इज द फोर्थ मोस्ट कॉमन नॉन ट्रोमैटिक न्यूरोलॉजिक डिसऑर्डर अकॉर्डिंग टू द कमीशन ऑन न्यूरो इमेजिंग ऑफ द इंटरनेशनल लीग अगेंस्ट एपिलेप्सी. ऑल द पेशेंट्स विद एपिलेप्सी शुड अंडरगो एन एमआरआई except those with very typical forms of primary generalized epilepsy or benign focal epilepsies of childhood with characteristic clinical features, early onset childhood epilepsy with occipital spikes, and adequate response to any anti-epileptic drugs. The etiologies of epilepsies are varied and multifocal in various cases. Therefore, the investigation of the underlying causes of seizure will depend upon the clinical context, in particularly the type of syndrome, age, types of seizures, associated diseases, presence or absence of progressive or static motor and cognitive dysfunction. In this context, in addition to EEG, neuroimaging techniques, in particular MRI, are the most important tools for determining the syndromic diagnosis and possible etiology of epilepsy. The most common causes of epilepsy are described here. They are such as mesangial temporal sclerosis, infections like NCCS, neurocystis sarcosis, tuberculoma, epileptogenic tumors like meningioma, neurocutaneous syndromes like tuberous sclerosis, developmental like hydropia, megalomeningitis, scars, and others such as calcified granulomatous lesion, cavernous hemangioma. The aims and objectives of this topic is to evaluate various causes of epilepsy on MRI brain using conventional and non-contrast MRI in conjunction with advanced MRI techniques such as MR spectroscopy in verification and differentiation of different lesions. To evaluate the MRI features of various causes of epilepsy through an optimized epilepsy protocol with adequate spatial resolution and multiplanar reformation. The materials and methods used here are: the study design is prospective observational study, sample size approximately 50 patients with the sign and symptom of seizure epilepsy and other epilepsy disorders during the study period have been followed. It's conducted at the SBKS Medical Institute, Vadodara, India. The study population was drawn from the patients who were referred to the Department of Radio Diagnosis in collaboration with all the departments. The materials and procedure before commencing the study, written informed consent was taken from all the patients. All patients were handled by the same doctor to minimize the biasness. Inclusion criteria include who had presented with all the seizure or epilepsy for the MRI brain in the Department of Radio Diagnosis, irrespective of the age and gender. Exclusion criteria include patient not giving the informed consent, patient in which MRI is contraindicated, such as patients with a pacemaker, metallic implants, and aneurysmal clips, patients with the claustrophobia. The study tool for this is 1.5 Tesla 16 channels MRI machine Philips. Yeah, the percentage of distribution of the cases based on age is 1 to 15 years include 18%, 16 to 30 years include 44%, 1 to 45 years include 22%, 46 to 60 years include 10%, and more than 60 years include 6%. On the basis of gender, male comprise of 66% and the female is of 34%. The male predominance is more as compared to the females. Distribution of cases based on MRI findings, the most common include granulomatous disease such as neurocystis sarcosis, tuberculoma, calcified granulomas, mesangial temporal sclerosis, and others as described in the table. Distribution of cases based on the type of epilepsy, generalized tonic-clonic includes 70%, partial includes 28%. Epilepsy is a chronic neurologic disorder characterized by spontaneous recurrent seizures. So most patients with epilepsy caused by generalized seizures respond to anti-epileptic drugs. One-third of those with the partial seizures are resistant to anti-epileptic drugs. In the patients, surgical resection of the brain lesion is often the only effective treatment. Patients presenting this seizure can have a wide range of MR imaging modalities or abnormalities depending upon the etiology. Patients presented with seizure of varying duration ranging from few days to few months. Generalized tonic-clonic seizure was the most common clinical diagnosis, constituting to about 72% of the cases. Some of the common cases have been discussed here, like granulomatous disease, neurocystic sarcosis. Cystic sarcosis is a major health problem in several Asian countries. It is the cause of epilepsy in about up to 50% of Indian patients presenting with partial seizures. The most common location of NCC lesion is brain parenchyma. Patients may have multiple lesions at different stages of evolution. Colloidal vesicular stage, the dying scolex. MR shows that the cyst fluid is highly hyperintense to CSF on T1 weighted images, then the scolex appears hyperintense on FLIR. Moderate to marked surrounding edema is present. Enhancement of the cyst wall is typically intense, ring-like, and oftenly slightly shaggy. The next one is tuberculoma. It is the second most common manifestation of neurotuberculosis, which is characterized by focal parenchymal infection with the central caseating necrosis. Lesions with iso or hypointensity on T1 weighted images and central hypointensity with the peripheral hyperintense rim on T2 weighted images categorizes it under the solid caseating granuloma. Since cellular components appear brighter, it is selectively specific for the tuberculoma. Thus, it has been shown that T1 weighted MR imaging is superior to MRS in characterization to such lesions. Calcified granulomatous lesion. Calcified granulomas are the result of post-inflammatory response. They form as a result of chronic infection, mostly due to neurocystic sarcosis and more commonly due to tuberculosis in our country. Having a large number of patients with granulomas, granulomatous disease, and a short history signifying that most patients are picked up in early course of disease. Mesangial temporal sclerosis. It is the second most common substrate associated with epilepsy in this study. We found that architectural distortion of hippocampus of patients with hippocampal sclerosis, which included hippocampal atrophy and loss of head, digitations, and signal alteration, was seen in most of the patients. Another one is tumor and tumor-like condition, that's low-grade glioma. It's the most common and it's histopathologically proven, and follow-up case of low-grade glioma is seen in this picture in the right high frontal temporal region and the post-operative and post-radiotherapy status. The image revealed altered signal intensity in right frontal temporal region with the adjacent extension and interval appearance of a small enhancing lesion in right insular context. With the surrounding areas of altered signal intensity, which is showing increased perfusion on perfusion scan, the described findings were suggestive of the recurrence. The above one is low grade. Now we'll see the high grade glioma. This is a known case of glioblastoma multiforme, it's a pathologically proven case. The study revealed presence of a large solid cystic lesion in a left parietotemporal and occipital lobe with the moderate perilesional edema. The lesion is compressing the left lateral ventricle with the dilatation of right lateral ventricle and significant midline shift towards right side. Oligodendroglioma. This is a post-operative case of anaplastic oligodendroglioma. Post-operative cystic encephalomyelitic changes are seen in right frontal cortical subcortical location with significant perifocal white matter, long TR hyperintensity showing heterogeneous post-contrast enhancement. Meningioma. This is a post-operative case of right parietal meningioma. The study revealed presence of a well-defined extra-axis homogeneous enhancing mass lesion with dural tail along the greater wing of sphenoid bone on the right side. Tuberous sclerosis. The study revealed presence of cortical ependymal nodules along the lateral ependymal surface of both lateral ventricles, left more than right, and the white matter radial migration lines. The conclusion is MR imaging is a superior neuroimaging modality with no radiation exposure and should be the first investigation of choice in epileptic syndrome, cerebrovascular disease with a seizure, developmental cortical malformation, and vascular malformation. In identifying certain lesions, location, extent of the lesions, and amount of findings are excellent, but has moderate sensitivity in patients with the generalized tonic-clonic seizures. It was observed that MR positivity was more in tonic seizures than of seizures, absence seizure, and motor seizure that most commonly affected the generalized tonic-clonic seizures cases. Our study observed that MRI with appropriate imaging protocols adds sensitivity and specificity in evaluation of syndromes. Thank you very much.